Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we will look at advanced tree structure, one of which is red-black tree. Red-black tree is a self-balancing binary tree in which every node has to follow the following properties. Property number one, every node of the red-black tree is either black or red. It cannot be same colors. Second property, root of the red-black tree is always black. Third property, there cannot be any two adjacent nodes of the same color, or I can say there cannot be any two nodes of the red color. These are the properties which every red-black tree has to follow. Then only that tree becomes a red-black tree. It is a self-balancing binary search tree. Let us begin with the topic. I've defined a class called as red-black node. Inside that, I've created two reference variables, left and right. After that, I've created variables element and color. Then we will go for the constructor of the class. How do you know this is the constructor? By looking at the class name and the constructor name. Inside this, we need to pass the parameters. This is very important. We should always go for the constructor in these cases. We have public red-black node of the parameter the element. This element, the element, is to be taken from the user, and this value is passed to the variables left and right through this reference variable. This the element null and null. So what do you understand from this is that this element value will be given to the element, the left will have the value null and right will have the value null. This is the one of the constructor of the class red-black node. Then we move to the another constructor of the same class. How do we understand the constructor? By looking at the class name and the constructor name. We have red black node. Inside this, we have the parameters to pass the value. First, we have the element, then LT, and then RT. We will pass this value, that is LT equal to left. That is LT value will be passed to the reference variable left, which is we have defined. Similar pattern, RT value will be passed to the right reference variable, and the element value will be passed to the variable element, and we will have another variable called as color, whose value will be taken from the L variable. This is how you pass the constructor values to the reference variables and normal variables. This is very important. We always need to have these values with a hand before going for the red-black tree. I've defined a class called as RB tree. Inside that, I have created the reference variable of the class red black node for the following variables, that is current, parent, grand, great, header. After that, I have created one another reference variable of the class red black node of the type static, whose value will be null node. This is very important. We need to pass this value. We will look at the function where we are going to pass the value. Let us look at that function. Static initializer for null node. Static null node will be equal to new red black node of the value 0. This will define for the red node. Okay, so we have null node equal to new red black node of the value 0. This will be creating the object of the class null node reference variable. Then we will pass the value of the left and right. How do you pass the value of left and right? We write down null node dot left equal to null node. And in this similar pattern, we are going to write for the right node. We are going to write null node dot right equal to null node. This is how you are going to pass the value for the left hand side and the right hand side. This is for the static initializer for the null node. Then we will go for the static variable values. We must remember we have the red black tree. In case of red black tree, we need to pass the values. We have kept the value of black as 1 and red as 0. So whenever in a tree it is written as 0, it means the color of that particular node is red. And whenever in the given tree it is written as 1, what does it mean? Is that the color of that particular node is black. We have to make sure the red-black tree follows the above three properties which I have discussed earlier. We write static final int black equal to 1, static final int red equal to 0. This is how you are going to write the values of variables. So you must remember 0 and 1 has some special meaning in case of red-black tree. Once we are done with the RB tree class definition, now we will move to the constructor of the RB tree. We write down public arbitrary with the parameter int neg info, that is negative information, or I can say variable information. Header equal to new red black node, that reference variable will be passed out. Now we will pass for the header. How do you going to write for the header? Header dot left, that is the left hand side of the header, is going to be null node. And in a similar pattern, we have header dot right equal to null node. These are going to practice the values of putting it into left and right through the header. Once we are done with the constructor of the class arbitrary, then we move to the another variables. Let's look at the another function. First function would be isEmpty. As the name suggests, it is going to check whether the red black tree is empty or not. Let's take an example, we want to delete something of the red black tree and it is empty. Can we delete? No. That's why we may have to make sure we need to check the function of isEmpty. We write down public boolean isEmpty. How going to return the value if it is true? We are going to return header.write equal to null node. If header.write is equal to null node, that value will be written up in case the tree is empty. That's why we need to write down the function isEmpty. Then we start making the tree logically empty. For this, we need to write down the function makeEmpty. This is very important. We need to make sure the tree is empty. For this, we are going to check whether the values are there. If it is not, then we are going to make it tree. While we are going to make it tree as empty, we need to pass the value and check that value. How do we need the values? Is through the right hand side. Hence, we write down header.write equal to null node. We have header.write equal to null node. So the null node value will be given to the header.write. This will make sure the tree is empty. Now we will write the function to insert the item into the red black tree. We have void insert int item. This value is to be taken from the user. Then we have current equal to parent equal to grand equal to header. So all these values will be having the same values. Then we will go for the each reference variable value. We have null node dot element equal to item. So the value which the user wants to insert is to be passed on to the null node dot element. Then we will go for the checking the conditions of each and every element which we want to insert into the given red black tree. We have while current dot element not equal to the item. So it is very important, the current element is not equal to item. Why this need to be checked? Because we don't want the duplication of values into the red black tree. So if this condition is true, then only the value will be passed. We have while current dot element not equal to item, in that case grand value will be given to the great. Parent value will be given to the grand and current value will be passed to the parent. This is how the transformation of values take place. I once again repeat it, grand is given to the great, parent value is passed on to the grand and current value is given to the parent. Then we will go for checking the value of current element. This is the element which we are going to deal with. We need to check its condition. We write down current equal to item less than current dot element. If it is true, then we have current dot left. If this condition false, then we have current dot right. So we always need to check whether the current element value is less than or greater than the item. That particular value of the item becomes the value of the current element. We have current equal to item less than current dot element question mark. This is called a ternary operations. Current dot left. If the condition is true, then we have current dot left. If the condition is false, then we have current dot right. Then we will go for the checking of the two childrens. We have the function to check if the two red childrens and fix it. Now why do we need to this performation? Because no two childrens, or we can say there can be no adjacent red nodes in the given red black tree. Hence we need to check if the two adjacent nodes are red. If so, then we need to fix it up. We have if current dot left dot color equal to red and current dot right color equal to red, then we go for the reorientation of the given red black tree. We have if current dot left dot color equal to red and current dot right color equal to red, then we call the function handle orient of the given item. If not, it means the insertion fails if the already value is present in the given red black tree. We have if current not equal to null node, then return the values which is current equal to new red black node in which we have the value of item, null node and null node. This is very important. If the current node is not equal to null node, in that case we need to pass the value of the current value back to the calling function. When this is done, then we need to check whether the item is less than the parent value or not. That is, the we have parent child relationship in this redpack tree. So we need to check whether the parent value is greater than or less than the given item which we want to insert into the redpack tree. Before this, we have checked whether the given item falls in the conditions of the redpack tree properties. We have if item less than parent dot element. If it is so, then we what we do is the pass the value of the current to the left hand side. Hence we write down if item less than parent dot element, in that case current value will be given to the parent dot left. If not, that means there is some problem, we need to handle it. So we write down else part, which is parent dot right equal to current. So the current value will be given to the parent dot right. And after that, once this is done, then again we need to call the handle function of reorientation of the item. This is very important in the case of redpack tree. Whenever we insert the items into the redpack tree, we make sure that the properties of the redpack tree are followed by each and every node in the given redpack tree. What are the properties? We have already discussed before only. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to Ikeda channel.